this talk is funnier for you because it's about ecology, not gadgets. And first of all, I want to say to tell you that we have brought this roadshow that we have written to explain what we are doing in our LTR site. We have brought some of them. We can take them from that table. We will both put there. So if you are really interested in this project, a big one, but we don't have so many. We don't have one for per person. So take it only if you are very interested. Yes. Well. Behind this title, there are different challenging or even weak questions. First of all is, how could we measure the conservation status of a given ecosystem? How could we create this indicator showing, following this framework, the OECD framework? And an even more complex question, how could we evaluate the conservation status of a socio-ecological spatial entity, like a municipality, for example? Well, in order to try to answer this question, we are designing and implementing an indicator system in our site. The first step to create this indicator system is to get relevant and up-to-date information about the processes and the structure that are taking place in our landscape. In the last three years, we have been implementing a monitoring program in Sierra Nevada following the Glocamore project and the experience that we have from LTR. Thanks to this monitoring program, we have more than 40 monitoring protocols that are collecting relevant information about the structure and the function of our ecological and socio-economical system. These protocols collect more than 100 environmental variables. For example, we have some bird transect that collect some kind of information. We also have phenology plots. We have information from the urban landscape showing, for example, electric consumption or some demographic variables, whatever. From each of these monitoring protocols, we obtain environmental variables. For example, we can obtain a flowering date for each species in this phenology plot, or we can obtain a species abundant in this bird transect, or electric consumption shown in gas. Kilowatts per hour or whatever. Sorry, I'm asking. Well, from this point, from the variable stage, we have followed two different frameworks, and I'm going to try to explain both of them. The first framework is the most challenging under a scientific point of view, but it is also the most difficult to accomplish because it has to be with the behavior, with the functioning of the system. To start with this first approach, we have to establish a relationship between those variables and some aspects of the functioning of those systems, the ecological and the socio-economical ones. For example, we can say that the abundance of birds has to be with the structure of that ecosystem. We can also say that the flowering date has to be with phenology, that is a function of the ecosystem. But we can also say that the electric consumption showed as kilowatts per hour has to be with the economy of this village, and the inhabitant has to be with the population. It's easy to derive this question. Well, following this reasoning, we have created a set of hierarchical list of aspects and attributes that relates the functioning of the system with with this aspect of our complex system. For example, in the ecological system, we have created a level called organization, another called function and residence. So all the variables that we are gathering from the monitoring programs are labeled with one of these aspects and attributes. We do the same, exactly the same, with the monitoring protocols coming from the socio-economical system. Actually, this is what End Europe has done in a different way. Ricardo has shown a table where we have been able to see the different aspects that this project has created. So this first approach has different ways of implementation, depending on the papers that you have previously read, I guess. Well, the next step is to add labels showing what kind of indicator we are creating in this particular case. For example, if we measure abundance of birds that has to do with the structure of the system, we are really creating a state indicator showing the state of the abundance of birds. And the same with phenology, and the same with this soil. This particular example are very interesting because these variables that affect to these two aspects of the socio-economical system can behave as state indicators for the socio-economical part of the system, but also as pressure indicator to the ecological part of the system. What a very important point of complexity to the discussion. Well, if we do that, after this step, what we have is a set of partial indicators showing the state of a given part of our system. But what is the real relationship between this indicator and the conservation status of the system? Because if we don't know if the state of phenology has something to do with the whole conservation status of this forest, for example. Another question is how could we integrate these indicators, these partial results, to obtain a single multimetric index? Well, we think that we as ecologists does not have knowledge enough to know this. What is the relationship between phenology of this plot and the whole conservation status of the system? Actually, in fact, we do not have even a single comprehensive definition for conservation status. this first approach is similar to the method that physicians use to evaluate if you are healthier or not. For example, they have lots of indicators that are based on variables that they measure with growth analysis, for example. If you do that growth analysis and they know that you have a high blood sugar, they know that you will probably have problems with your pancreas. Or if you use a thermometer to measure your temperature and you have a fever, you will probably have an infection. This seems simple for us, but they have spent hundreds of years to learn that relationship between the variable that they measure and the real internal process of that particular person. We think that we don't have that knowledge at an ecosystem level in our subject. That is why we are also working in a different approach, a second one that is much more simple and much more pragmatic. Because the thing is that we need to create indicator system in order to manage the nature. Managers need to know how the system is performing. So this second approach has also to be with the first one. Let's imagine that physicians does not have the information that they have nowadays. How do you think they could know what is your health condition. A good idea could be to assess your capacity of doing a given work. For example, a person that is able to run for 5 minutes could be considered as healthier than another that is only able to run for 30 seconds. It's a simple question, but I think you get the idea. So to translate this idea to our problem, the concept of work could be means the capacity of a given ecosystem to provide benefits to human societies, that is, ecosystem services. So what if we create an indicator system using the concept of work, that is ecosystem services, instead of the concept of internal force that we don't really understand yet. If we are able to do that, we are able to quantify some of the important ecosystem services using these same variables, we will be able to know how much work a given ecosystem is able to do. This could be an example. From this data, we could be able to quantify supporting and cultural services from this one we're saying, and we have some other monitoring protocols that are able to give us information about provisioning services, regulating services, or whatever. And this second approach has another advantage. We can quantify the demands of human societies have of this given ecosystem services. For example, this variable could be expressed as the energy demand that these people have. And the same with this one. So we could be able to create that single multimetric index to this municipality, establishing a sort of balance between the offers and the demands. So we will be able to create a sort of that kind of indicator system. So as a conclusion, we are just proposing two compatible and complementary approaches. We are not saying that the first is worse or the second is worse. They are complementary because the first one allows us to know how the system is working, and the second one allows us to work and to give information to the managers that have to do their work. And that's all. Thank you.
Very short comment. You are mentioning the processes that are quite difficult to measure. I guess it is not easy, but one can measure primary production as an energy budget or units, but it is difficult to measure other functions like denitrification or denitrification, removal of nitrogen or regulation by forest of the climate. So it's conceptually very, very nice, but it's a step forward, which is measurable.
We are in the conceptual step. But I think this second approach is going to be easier to implement than the first one, because manager need to do something.
Well, one way is to have models for simulating things.
Absolutely. Thank you.
I will conclude with Mark Franzen.